Hello and welcome to Redstabler channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use type.js, a JavaScript library that will help you create a typing animation on your web page, which can be a good idea for a welcome message to your website visitor or simulating a console and much more. Let's check it out. First, let's start with downloading the latest version from GitHub and include the script to your page using script tag. Now you have two ways to provide the input string to type.js. First is to have the library read the text from existing div element, and second is to use an array of strings. Let's try the first method first. Here's the example text separated into two paragraph tags inside the div element. Create a new span element that you want to create a typing animation, and create a new type object and pass the span element ID followed by a string element option, which specify the ID of existing div element containing the text. And here is the result. It's a little bit too fast, so let's customize the typing speed and backspacing speed by adding the following options. You'll see that the type.js will automatically hide the existing div and display only the span with typing animation. The benefit of using this method is the search engine will be able to see your text and index it. Another method is you can specify the array of strings like this. At the current moment that I'm creating this tutorial, you will see that the cursor isn't blinking. Someone is working on this feature, but for now you will have to manually add extra CSS for the blinking effect like this. You can find the link at video description box below for the code. Another issue that many people have experienced with type.js is that the cursor will be placed on a separated new line on block display element. So to solve this issue, you will need to add display inline or inline block to the target element. There are lots more options available in type.js. For example, you can loop the animation by setting loop to true or shuffle the text sentences between each type. You can find and try them all on the project documentation page. So that's the basic of how to use type.js. Hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and please like to support us or subscribe to stay tuned for more interesting JavaScript library and tutorial like this. Thanks for watching. Bye.